you students, today we will do the last two exercises of the geometry. Now the section formula. Suppose we are having two points x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2 in the space, and a point R divides a line segment PQ in m ratio n. Then we can find the coordinates of point R using the section formula as mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n, and mz2 plus nz1 upon m plus n. Now, if this point is dividing PQ externally in the ratio m ratio n, then in that case, the coordinates of point R will be mx2 minus nx1 upon m minus n. Similarly, in y and z coordinate, in place of plus, we will use minus. If R is the midpoint of PQ, then in that case, m ratio n will be 1 ratio 1. So the coordinates of R in that case will be equal to x1 plus x2 by 2, y is equal to y1 plus y2 by 2, and z equal to z1 plus z2 by 2. So based on it, let us do a few questions of the exercise. Find the coordinates of point which divides the line segment joining the points minus 2, 3, 5 and 1, minus 4, 6 in the ratio 2, ratio 3 internally and as well as externally. So let the point P, X, Y, Z divides it in the ratio 2, ratio 3. Then the coordinates of P will be equal to, X coordinate will be equal to 2 into 1 plus 3 multiplied by minus 2 divided by m plus n, which is 2 plus 3. So the x coordinate is 1 by 5, minus 4 by 5. Similarly, we can find y coordinate as 2 multiplied by minus 4, the y coordinate of B, plus 3 multiplied by 3 divided by 5. So it becomes 1 by 5, and similarly we can find the z coordinate. When R divides PQ externally, then in place of plus, we will use minus. So we get 2 into 1 minus 3 into minus 2 divided by 2 minus 3, that is minus 8. Similarly, we can find the y and z coordinate. Next point is, given these three points, P, Q and R, they are collinear, find the ratio in which Q divides PR. So let us take this ratio as K ratio 1. So then the point coordinates of Q will be equal to 9 into K plus 3 multiplied by 1 divided by K plus 1. Similarly, Y coordinate will be equal to K into 8 plus 1 into 2 divided by K plus 1. And similarly, we can find the Z coordinate. Now, this coordinates of Q, they are already given. So by equating the corresponding coordinates, we can find the value of K. We can use any of the equations here. This is by equating the coordinates of X, this is by equating the coordinates Y, and this is for Z. So you can use any of the equation to find the value of K. If we are using the first one, we will get 9k plus 3 equal to 5k plus 5 after cross multiplying. From here, you get k equal to 1 by 2. Now the ratio is k is to 1, it becomes 1 is to 2. Next point is, question is, find the coordinates of points which trisect the line segment joining the points. Trisect means dividing it into three equal parts. So we will take two points R and S on the line segment PQ, which divides it into three equal parts. Then the point R divides PQ in 1 ratio 2. So using section formula, we can find the coordinates of the point R as 1 into 10 plus 2 multiplied by 4 divided by 1 plus 2. Similarly, Y and Z coordinates we can find. So the coordinates of R we get 6 minus 4 and minus 2. Now the coordinates of point S can be found in by two ways. Either we can use this same method as for finding R, that S is dividing PQ in 2:1, so you can use section formula, or you are seeing that S is the midpoint of RQ also, so you can use the midpoint formula also. So we are using the midpoint, so S will be equal to 6 plus 10 by 2 and like Y and Z coordinates. So we can find the coordinates of S as 8 minus 10 and 2. Now the coordinates of centroid of the triangle. Centroid means the point of concurrence of medians. It is given by x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3 and z1 plus z2 plus z3 by 3. So let us do the next few questions of miscellaneous exercise. Three vertices of parallelogram ABCD are given. Find the coordinates of the fourth vertex. चौथा vertex हमें निकालना है. तो यहाँ पर हमारे पास क्योंकि A और C vertex given और हमें पता है कि parallelogram के diagonals bisect करते हैं. So N is the midpoint of AC as well as BD. So first we will find the coordinates of M using A and C point. Using the midpoint formula, the coordinates of M are 3 minus 1 by 2 minus 1 plus 1 by 2 and 2 plus 2 by 2, that is 1, 0, 2. And coordinates of BD will be equal to x plus 1 by 2, y plus 2 by 2, z minus 4 by 2. Now, they are the coordinates of M point. So, equating the coordinates from 1 and 2, we get x plus 1 by 2 by 2, x plus 1 by 2 equal to 1. Similarly, y plus 2 by 2 equal to 0 and z minus 4 by 2 equal to 2. Solving the three equations, we get x, y and z as 1 minus 2, 8, means this is the fourth vertex of the parallelogram. Next is, if origin is the centroid of the triangle with vertices P, Q and R, then find the values of A, B, C in it. Since the coordinates of centroid, they are given by x1 plus x2 by plus x3 by 3, y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3 and z1 plus z2 plus z3 by 3. So we can write it as 2A minus 4 plus 8 by 3, similarly y and z coordinates. Now the centroid is given at origin, that is 0, 0, 0. So equate all the three coordinates equal to 0. So we get 2a plus 4 by 3 equals 0. Similarly, by equating y coordinate and z coordinate, we get the values of a, b and c. The last one, a point r with x coordinate 4 lies on the line segment joining the points p and q. Find the coordinates of point r. Now, since r lies on pq, so let us take R divides PQ in K:1. So by the section formula, we can write the coordinates of R as K into 8 plus 1 into 2 by K plus 1. Similarly, Y coordinate we can write as K into 0 plus 1 into minus 3 by K plus 1 and like this. Now, we are given the X coordinate, so we can equate it equal to 4. So 8k plus 2 by k plus 1 equal to 4. So on solving it, we get k equal to half. Now put the values of k in y and z coordinate. We can find the y and z coordinate as minus 2 and 6. So the coordinates of R are 4 minus 2, 6. That's all for today. Now complete the two exercises. Thank you.